say the man who died was simply walking down the street when the suspect came out of the club swinging a baseball bat. A woman who was critically injured was inside the club when she was attacked, and one of her friends tells me she is facing a very long road of recovery ahead of her.
Denver police were back out doing community outreach, providing resources to those impacted by this horrible incident.
I immediately broke into tears.
Karina Stonecipher got the call Sunday afternoon. One of her best friends was one of the victims of the brutal beating at PT's Show Club.
It's obviously horrific. I mean, I don't know how someone could ever do something like this.
She says she's been friends with Denise Villalobos for 10 years.
She has a heart of gold, and she's just kindest person I've ever met.
And Karina says it's mind-boggling that someone would attack her.
She has a lot of trauma to her head being the main issues that she's going through right now. She has some other issues like hands and stuff.
According to the probable cause statement, police arrived within 2 minutes and saw the suspect in the parking lot armed with a baseball bat standing near one of the victims.
We've got a party down in the parking lot on the south corner. We have an uncooperative male with a bat.
The suspect refused to drop the bat, and that's when officers tased him and took him into custody.
She's just in a really difficult state right now. She's doing a lot better than she was yesterday.
Karina says she's focused on her friend Denise, who has always been there for her, and now she wants to help her.
I created a GoFundMe account for her. She obviously has bills of her own, and she's out of work now, and will be for a while, more than likely. So hopefully people can go to her GoFundMe account and help her donate whatever they can. People aren't able to donate, just keep her in your thoughts and prayers.
And we have a link to that GoFundMe account on our website, KDVR.com. For the suspect, he is 41-year-old Ryan Ashland, being held now on investigation of first-degree murder as well as second-degree assault. Police have not yet provided a motive for the attack. Reporting live from Southwest Denver, Deborah Takahara, Fox 31.